The bench press is unusual in a couple of respects. Obviously, it's the only movement performed laying down, or it should be. If you're doing the squat or the power clean on your back, I'd like to see a video of that. Moreover, the bench is the only movement in our system of training in which the bar path is explicitly non-vertical. The movement starts at the top, directly over the shoulder joints, but at the bottom, it's more or less over the nipples, with the humeri, or upper arms, at an angle with respect to the chest. See, if you were a bench-pressing robot, a bench terminator, we would have designed you so that, at the bottom, the bar would be directly over the point of rotation, the shoulder joints. This would zero out any moment around the shoulder, and the bar would lock out at the top at the same position relative to the shoulder joint directly overhead, also with a zero moment, making the movement more efficient. But you're not a terminator, as far as we know, and it turns out you can't do this. Holding a heavy bar directly over the shoulder joint at the bottom impinges soft tissue, which really sucks, so we have to bow to anatomical realities and relieve this impingement by holding our arms at an angle at the bottom. This means that at the bottom, we have a moment arm that's trying to rotate the bar in the sagittal plane. So this presents us with a bit of a biomechanical conundrum. We want to increase churning force around the shoulder joint in the transverse plane while minimizing churning force in the sagittal plane. We can do this by pulling the shoulder blades together behind us and tucking them down and raising the chest, what I call the pinch and tuck. Some coaches will tell you to put your shoulder blades in your back pocket, and that works too. However we cue it, it helps us resolve our mechanical problem. Pulling the shoulder blades down the torso, the tuck part, or the back pocket part, brings the shoulder closer to the bar at the bottom, decreasing the moment arm or lever arm between the bar and the shoulder, thereby reducing the churning force in the sagittal plane. Pinching the shoulders together behind and raising the chest reduces protraction of the scapulae, which adds nothing meaningful to the movement, but more importantly, it increases the angle of attack of the pectoral muscles on the humerus, bringing it closer to 90 degrees. The closer to 90 degrees the force is applied to a lever arm, the more churning force can be produced for any given force. In other words, tucking the shoulder and raising the chest maximizes the churning force around the shoulder joint in the transverse plane. So, when we pinch and tuck and raise our chest, we optimize the biomechanics of the bench as much as possible within the constraints of our anatomy. So, when we unrack the bar, we want to push ourselves into the arched, pinched, tucked position using our legs to drive our upper back, which is the foot of the movement, hard into the bench. We perform our rep, pushing up on the way down, touching the chest softly, and driving up hard. And this is where we'll screw everything up. It is a very, very common form error for athletes to punch at the top of the bench. The bar goes to where it started, but the lifter gives himself an extra inch or two of movement at the top and loses the entire setup as a result. There's no way it's worth it. The amount of extra work done is negligible, and in the process of getting that tiny bit of extra work, you give up your biomechanical advantage and have to completely reset your shoulders before you go again. And that extra work isn't really worth it either. The moral of the story is that you must not punch the bench press. Keep the movement short. Put the bar right back where it started, both in your visual field, superimposed on the ceiling, and at the same height it was at when you were pinched, tucked, and arched at the bottom of the rep. Your bench press will be stronger and more consistent from rep to rep, and you'll make better progress. Thanks for watching. Stay strong and stay healthy.